Hello everyone, this is Yana here at Spellbinders, and thank you for joining me today. In this video, I'll show you how to create a simple Christmas card featuring Spellbinders 3D shading stamps. I'm going to be using the Holly and Berries stamp to create both the background and the focal point on my project. Let's get started. Here's the closer look at the stamp I'll be playing with today. The image is made up out of tiny little dots. Where the dots are grouped closer together, the image will stamp darker. Where the dots are spread further apart, the image will stamp lighter. Now, these stamps are available in both cling versions and mounted, wood-mounted versions, but the wood-mounted can only be found at places like Michael's. If you're shopping for these online, you'll probably find them in cling versions only. I've already created an A2 tufflating card base, and I have an old paper distress ink. I'm going to ink up my stamp and stamp it repeatedly onto my card base to create a patterned paper-like background. I'm inking up my stamp and trying to rotate it every time I make an impression to create the illusion of a beautiful pattern. I try not to overlap the images, but even in places where I do overlap, these still look very beautiful and natural, very organic, I think. I'm going to set this aside and we'll work on my focal point now. I will be doing no line Copic coloring, so I'm using specialty Copic blending paper. This is expressed blending paper, and I'm going to go ahead and stamp my image onto this square using the same old paper distress ink. The reason I'm using this type of ink is because the alcohol ink in the markers will eat up, so to speak, the ink, and it will disappear once I finish my coloring, and therefore this image will have no visible stamped lines. The reason I'm using this particular color of ink is because green will be dominant on my image, so even if I have some of this ink left on my final colored piece, it will not distract and will not look out of place. I stamped my image closer to the right-hand side of my square because I am leaving some room for sentiment to the left. Like I mentioned, I'll be using Copic markers and I'm going to start with the berries. I like to start with my darkest color first when I'm doing no-line coloring. So I'm using R39 as my darkest color, R29 as my medium color, and R22 as my lightest color. To color the leaves and the branch, I'm using several greens. I'm starting with G28 as my darkest color, using YG63 as my medium color, and YG61 as my lightest color. I'm going to play some music and speed the coloring part up to show you more of the coloring process. I'm going to use a circle die and will die cut a circle to place onto my card. I'm also going to die cut another circle, a slightly smaller one, out of fun foam, and I'll use this fun foam to foam mount my colored circle onto my card. I'm also going to add some shadows and color in the background, and I'm using W7, W4, and W1 markers for this. I'm going to add some white highlights onto the berries, and I'm using a white gel pen to add little white dots onto each of the colored berries here. I also heat embossed a sentiment, and I used white embossing powder. And finally, I'm going to adhere the fun foam circle onto the colored circle, and will adhere both onto my card. As a one final touch, I'm going to use a clear glitter pen and add lots of shimmer to the leaves and to the berries. So here's a closer look at this card created using Spellbinders Holly and Berries 3D Shading Stamp. If you have any questions about this card, please leave them in the comments section below. And be sure to subscribe to Spellbinders YouTube channel for more education and inspiration. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye!